teaching, research and administration. He has published over 15 books, 6 book chapters, 23 technical articles in CSI Communications magazine, 24 technical blogs, articles in Electronics for You magazine, 5 articles in Open Source for You magazine, and over 100 publications in highly cited journals and conferences. Some of his professional awards include faculty with maximum publishing in CSI Communications 2017-19, International Data Science Writer of the Year 2019, MTC Global Outstanding Researcher Award, Contributors Competition Winner July 2019 to December 2019 by Data Science Foundation, Inspiring Authors of India, Deloitte Innovation Award for Smart India Hackathon 2018, Patent Publish Award, Impactful Author of the Year 2017-18. His research interests are artificial intelligence, cloud computing, and IoT. He is serving as a reviewer and editorial board member of many reputed journals and acted as a session chair and technical program committee member of national conferences and international conferences at Vietnam, China, America, and Bangkok. He has published more than 21 patents on IoT applications and 1 granted copyright. I request Dr. Balakrishnan sir to please take over and share his view with us. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, yes, sir. Good morning, sir. Is it viewable? That screen is viewable, sir?
You share PPT, na? Not yet, sir. PPT.
So what about now, sir?
Not yet, sir. You can share the PPT, sir. You are the presenter, so you can share it.
Yeah, I shared. Is it viewable?
Not yet, sir.
What about now?
No, sir. Not it. Not visible.
Is it okay?
No, sir.
See, somebody is past my sharing. That's why it's not viewable. Here I am getting message. The sharing is passed until you return to the shared window. That's somebody's. Can you give the rights to me then?
Just a minute.
Now is it okay?
Now you try, sir, one second. Yes, sir, now it is visible. Balakrishnan, sir. Hello. We can see the PPT, sir, now.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes. Now PPT is visible, sir. You can start the session.
Yeah. Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for your nice introduction, sir. It gives me a great pleasure for me to extend my wishes to all the participants. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Okay? Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. So thank you so much for giving such an opportunity. So today's topic is big data driven solution to combat the COVID-19. So as per that, big data, the data in today's business and the technology world, it is indispensable. So the big data technologies and initiatives are rising to analyze the data for the gaining insights that can help in making strategic decisions. So the concept evolved at the beginning of 21st century, and every technology giant is now making use of that big data technologies. So the big data refers to vast and voluminous data sets that may be structured or unstructured or semi-structured like that. So this massive amount of data is produced every day, and every day is a business and users also. So whenever the big data analytics is a process of examining the large data sets to underline the insights and patterns. So the data analytic field in itself is vast. So today we'll discuss some of the big data concept, big data tools, and big data analytics also. So the, you know, the flow of the today's session, the outline of today's session is start with the introduction about the big data. And when I go for the big data, then what type of preparation or what type of preliminary things to be needed while using that big data concept? And what are the different types of tools used in the big data? And what are the top big data technologies are there? At present, what type of technology, big data technologies we are using? And end up with that research project based on the COVID-19. So some of the research project is going on based on that COVID-19, based on the concept of big data. So that is the end of the thing. So these are the outline of today's session. So first we'll start with that introduction. So as per that, the big data may well be the next big thing in the IT world. So whenever we are in the IoT world, whenever we are saying the IoT world or artificial intelligence world, without big data, without the big data concept, it won't be working. So whenever we go for that. Is it okay? Can you hear me and that screen is viewable? Visible? Snehal ma'am?
Snehal ma'am? Sir, visible? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Please make the full screen, sir.
Yeah, I selected full screen only.
No, it is not showing full screen, sir. Please make it full screen, right? It will be more visible, sir.
Sir, excuse me, you can go with slideshow.
Slideshow
will automatically come in the full screen.
Excuse me.
Sir, go to slideshow.
Yeah, I made it like that, ma'am. I made it like that only.
I didn't see for you, it will bigger.
Yeah.
So on the top side, you can have not like that, sir. Not like that, sir. Here slideshow. So from beginning.
Yeah. Like that only I made it. Yeah, I made it like that. Now is it okay?
Sir, it is still showing in the editing mode. You can put it on the slideshow mode. You can just press F5, sir, and share your presentation.
Yes. That's the thing. So usually I'm doing like that. What about now?
No, sir. It's still showing the same slides.
Okay.
What about now?
No, no sir, sir, not yet. Please press F5, sir. F5.
Yeah. I made it like F5. That only. I made it like that only.
Or make it slideshow on.
Yeah, slideshow also. Hello. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Now it is okay, sir. Hello, Bala sir. Now it is visible. Full screen, sir. You can start, sir. Hello, Bala sir, am I audible, sir?
त्यांना स्वतः स्वतःहून उलट जेवढं लांब राहता येईल तेवढं राहणार. तर तो मूर्ख आहे जरा.
कॅन यू हियर मी नाऊ?
हा येस सर.
सारखी येतो.
बाला सर प्लीज स्टार्ट द सेशन.
येस येस येस.
नाही नाही.
What about the full screen is viewable?
Yes, yes, sir. Full screen is viewable.
Yeah. So sorry for the interruption. So the big data, at present we are in the IoT world. So whenever we are focusing about the IoT world, the big data is very important. So the big data may well be the next big thing in the IoT IT world, that is information technology world. So the big data burst upon the scene in the first decade of the 21st century. So the first organization to embrace it were the online and startup firms. The firms like Google, eBay, and LinkedIn, and some Facebook were built around the big data from the beginning itself. So whenever they started that big data concept, they started their concept from the earlier itself, the starting itself. So like many new information technologies, nowadays we are using that, so many technologies. So all the technologies that big data can bring about the dramatic to perform a computing task are the new product or a serving service offering. So some of the things in that area that big data will be useful in new information technologies like that. So what is big data? So whenever I go for that big data, here the algorithms and predictive analytics. So the algorithms and the predictive analytics are the future. So the future world fully depends on that algorithm as well as predictive analytics. So whenever go for that big data, here the first step of the big data is the accumulation of second step, we have to analytics. So we go for the analytics. That is the second step. So after that, with the final step is to create the algorithm that deliver the actionable insights as services to the customers and the prospects. So these are the things. So whenever go for the big data, the first point, the first step is very important step, that is the accumulation of the data. The data accumulation is very important. The second thing, we go for the analytics of data, that is identifying the patterns and opportunities. And final step is to create algorithm that deliver the actionable insights as services to the customers and some prospectors. So that is the thing. There are countless examples of this, including the automated we may say the automated stock market timing, arbitrage trading, some sort of medical diagnostics, pharmaceutical procurement, weather forecasting model, internet search engines, and some sort of medical oriented application, even for the journalism, when I go for the sports oriented journalism. So the big data is very, very important thing. So the algorithm, whenever the big data, the algorithm are the final link between the big data and the revenue. So that is a very important thing. So the big data and algorithms also form the foundation of virtual reality and artificial intelligence concept. So that is a very important. Say at present, as I already told you, that at present we are in the IoT world. So all the way we are followed with that artificial intelligence and virtual reality thing. So whenever we go for the virtual reality and artificial intelligence, big data and algorithm. So big data with some algorithmic things is a very important. It's a foundation for virtual reality as well as the artificial intelligence. So as the computing power continues to increase and the technology continues to evolve, the trend in big data will directly impact the development of these other related fields. So that is the thing, whenever the technology increases and automatically some computing power also increases, then the trend in the big data will directly impact the development of these other related fields. So in that case, we will say the machine learning. The machine learning will inevitably improve the performance in nowadays we are using the autonomous driving vehicle and some sort of augmented reality interfaces for the gaming purpose or some other purpose. We are using augmented reality. So in that case, the big data will be very useful. So in new field like big data, the best way to do is to follow the companies on the forefront of innovation. So some of the leading big data and innovators include, we may say the SAP, some companies, some of the leading companies, the innovators using the big data concept. Example, we may say SAP, the SAP mainly for explore the world of big data. Oracle, the Oracle for the foundation for the data innovation. And IBM, mainly the IBM is a big data at the speed of business. And so many things, Dera Data, Cloud Era, we may say the Kevlar Packard and MapR. The MapR is mainly for the converged data platform. And apart from that, we are using the Amazon Web Services. So the Amazon Web Services mainly for the cloud computing services. So like that. So like that it is going on. So what is the big data? So whenever we go for the big data is similar to the small data, but bigger in size. But having the data bigger, it requires different approaches. So whenever the data is bigger, the big data requires some approaches. The approaches may be in terms of techniques, tools, and architecture. So the upcoming slides, we will discuss about what are the different techniques or what are the tools and architectures we are using. So that it's a very important approaches for making the big data somewhat efficient way or effective way. And apart from that, and aim, the big data, and I aim to solve the new problem or old problem in a better way. So with the help of the big data, the old problem, all the databases can be converted and the databases will be stored for the future use. So that will be with the help of the big data, easily we can do it. And big data generate the value from the storage and the processing of very large quantities of digital information, but that cannot be analyzed with the traditional computing techniques. So that is the one, we may say, one drawback. So even though we are generating value from the large amount of storage, as well as the processing of the data is a very large quantity. So that is also big data. So the, what is a big data? So whenever, that is from the, we are starting from 2017 to 22. So we are the 17, we are using that is the 35 billion revenue through the big data concept. And 2020, we are getting that, we got that 56 billion revenue. And 2022, we are planning to that make it 70 billion through that big data technologies or big data architectures. So that is a very important thing in the big data. So big data market, the revenue forecast is actually from 2017 to 22 is given in this diagram. That is the thing. So the Walmart handled more than 1 million customers transactions every hour. So that is a very important thing. So whenever the Facebook handles the 40 billion photos from its user base, and decoding the human genome, that is originally took over 10 years to process, but now it can be achieved within a week. So that is achievements of big data concept. So this is an overview of that big data. Actually, next, how that we are making the big data, and what are the important parameters or what are the important characteristics of big data? So we may say the 5C, 6C, 7C like that. So many V's are there, 5. So here we are focusing about the 5 V's, volume, velocity, variety, veracity. Apart from that veracity, we are following about value also. So that value, it's nothing but money. What about the money of that? So that is the thing. So in recent years, the big data was defined by the 4 V's. But later on, it converted into 5B. Then after the 6B, 7B, 8B, like that, will going on. So this term, this characteristics of big data as follows. First thing, volume. So volume is nothing but the data at rest. So if we see the big data as a pyramid, the volume is a base. So volume is very important. The volume is a base of the big data concept. So the name big data itself is related to the size, which is enormous. So volume is a huge amount of data. So whenever we go for focusing about the volume is a huge amount of data. Yes, ma'am? Yeah? Hello? What can I do? But is it their problem or are you getting it? Are you seeing it?
Share again.
ओके ओके डिले डिले टाइप ओके ओके
PPT is now visible. Start sessions.
See the introduction part already we discussed, is it? So next I will go with that. What is big data? What is data? So here something. Some make it 5 V's. So at present that we are using 6V, 7V also. So as per that 5V here, we are starting with volume, velocity, variety, capacity, intensity, and value. So volume is nothing but a data at rest. So if we see the big data as a pyramid, here the volume is a base. So volume is a base of that big data concept. So the name big data itself is related to the size, which is enormous. So volume is a huge amount of data. So to determine the volume of the value of data or the size of data that plays a very vital role in big data concept. So if the volume of data is very large, then it is actually considered as a big data. That is based on that volume only the concept arises with the big data concept. So this means whether the particular data can actually be considered as a big data or not is dependent upon the volume of data only. So hence, while dealing with that big data, it is necessary to consider a characteristics volume. For example, in the year 2016, they estimated the global mobile traffic was 6.2, that is a 6.2 billion gigabytes, that is a exabytes per month. Also the year 2020, we will have almost billion GB, that is a 40,000 exabytes of data we are utilizing. Now for the global mobile traffic. So that's why all the way we are using the big data concept. So the volume is very important in that big data. So second thing is the velocity. The velocity is nothing but the data in motion. See, the velocity refers to the high speed of accumulation of data. So the data accumulation is started with that velocity. So in big data velocity, the data flows in from the different sources like machines or some sort of networking. Take it from the social media, take it from the mobile phone, etc. So these are the input, or these are the different sources for the velocity. So there is a massive and continuous flow of data. So this determines the potential of data, how fast the data is generated and processed to meet the demand. So whenever go for the velocity, here the sampling data that can help in dealing with the issue like that velocity. As an example, we may say that there are more than 3.5 billion searches per day that made it on that Google. So as per the Google research, 3.5 billion searches is made it per day. And also the Facebook. So the Facebook users also increasing by 22% approximately per year. So that is also happening. So in that case, the velocity is very important. So that is a movement of the data, so that data in motion, so that is very important. The third V in that big data is a variety. So the variety means the data in many forms. There is a different form. It may be the structured, semi-structured, or that unstructured like that. So when I go for that variety, the data in many form, it refers to the nature of data that is a structured or semi-structured or unstructured. So it is also referred to the heterogeneous sources. So the data may be data in many forms mean that it may be the different sources, that is the heterogeneous sources. So the variety is basically the arrival of data from new sources. So that are both inside and outside of an enterprise. So suppose, for example, structured data. So this data is basically an organized data. So it generally refers to the data that has defined the length and format of data. That is a structure of data. It having the proper, it's organized data. It having the defined length as well as the format of the data. The second thing is a semi-structured data. Semi-structured data, the data is basically semi-organized one. It is generally a form of data that do not conform to the formal structure of data. See the example log files. We may say the log files are the semi-structured data. third thing is unstructured data. So this is unstructured data is basically from the unorganized data. So it generally refers to the data that does not fit neatly into the traditional row as well as the column structure of the relational databases. So the example, we may say the text, pictures, and some sort of videos or the unstructured data, so which can be stored in the form of rows and columns. So that is the unstructured data. So fourth one is a veracity. So the veracity is nothing but here the data in doubt. So we are using the uncertainty of data, that is the data is inconsistency. So it refers to the inconsistencies and uncertainty in data. So that is the data which is available can sometimes get messy and quality and accuracy are difficult to control. So that's why we are saying that veracity means it's an inconsistency like that. So the big data is also available, the variable, because of the multitude of data dimensions. So resulting from multiple disparate data types and sources. Example of veracity, we may say data in bulk could create confusions, whereas a less amount of data could convey the half or incomplete information about the particular things. So that is a veracity. And fifth B is nothing but value. The value is nothing but data into money. So we are making that all the data, converting that data into money. So as per the thing, the volume, V is the bottom of the pyramid, but the value is the top of the pyramid. So the V for value, the value sits at the top of the big data pyramid. So after having the four Vs into the account, there comes into one more V that is called as a value. So the value is nothing but the bulk of data having no value is no good to the company unless you turn it into something useful like that. So this is some characteristics of 5Vs, that is started with the volume, velocity, variety, and veracity. So what are the characteristics of big data? So already we discussed here the volume. The volume means large volume of data we are using it, that is the quantity and size. So there is a 1 petabyte like that, so 1024 terabyte. The next is the variety is nothing but the variety may be a type and nature of the data. It may be a text or image or audio or video like that. So next thing, velocity. The velocity is nothing but all the way. At present, we are using all the real-time applications, weather forecasting and all other things using the velocity. That is the frequency of generation and process. And the fourth one is the veracity. So veracity is nothing but quality and value. So that value is the outcome. That in veracity of the outcome of the veracity is given to the value. So that is a fifth B, that is a value. So here this is a overview characteristics of the big data using the different 5 Bs. So starting with the volume, veracity, variety, velocity and value. So this is a thing. So next, we are using a different big data landscape. See, when I go for the landscape, the most important changes and opportunities propagating through the big data landscape in 2020. So the first, we may start with the hybrid cloud becomes the default. In 2020 big data landscape, cloud technology, actually in that cloud technology, the hybrid clouds become the default. So the hybrid cloud means a mixture of an on-premises platform and cloud platforms will probably become the new normal in 2020. So that is one important big data landscape in 2020 is the hybrid clouds. Second thing is more business types, that is a turn to the data mapping. So the coming year, we'll see an explosion in the number of businesses and industrial sectors is turning to the data mapping technology, including GIS, that is a geospatial information system like that. So that is the second technology. The third one, AI, artificial intelligence, it puts the untapped enterprise data to the work. And fourth one is a big data as a service. So when I go for that big data landscape in 2020, the fourth important thing is that big data as a service steps up all the talent shortages and like that. So more specifically, the big data infrastructure entails the tools and the agents that collect the data, the software systems and physical storage media that store the data, and the network that transfer the data and the application environment that holds the analytics tools that analyze it and backup or achieve the infrastructure that backs it, backup it up. So that is the thing. So as per things here, the whenever the big data landscape in 2020 here, we are using so six different things. One is starting with the infrastructure. So as per the infrastructure, here as per the infrastructure, we are using NSQL, NoSQL databases, Hadoop, new SQL databases and collection and transport some massive parallel processing databases and cluster services, storage and crowdsourcing, security. So these are some of the landscape services based on the infrastructure. Second thing is based on the analytics. So whenever we go for based on the analytics, here the big data analytics is very important. Refer to the analyzing the large and disparate sets of structured and unstructured data that bring useful insight by the analyst. So in that analytics, we are using analytics solutions, some sort of data visualization tools, statistical computing tools, social media tools, sentiment analysis, analytical services, some sort of big data search engines or search tools, IT analytics. So so many tools we are using under the analytics part. Another big data landscape in 2020 is the applications. As per the application concern, here we are using that some ad optimizations and publisher tools, marketing tool like that. And the fourth important thing is the data sources. So here we are using different data sources from the data marketplaces and different data sources, and even for the ad optimization also. Apart from that, we are using here the cross infrastructure and analytics here all the way. So many industries, so many IT companies, they are using the cross infrastructure and analytics. We'll see it in the upcoming slide. And apart from that, here open source project. So some of the open source project also we are using it for making that cloud, that big data analytics. So start with the framework, query, data access, some sort of coordination and workflow, real time statistical, some sort of statistical tool, machine learning tool, and cloud deployment like that. So these are the some of the open source project available in that big data landscape in 2020. So next, why big data? So what is the need for big data? So whenever go for the growth of big data, it's needed increase of the storage capacity. So as per that 5e characteristics of 5e of that big data, here the storage capacity is increased and the processing power also increased and availability of the data. So the data is available in the different type or different format. So that is the main purpose. That's why we go for that big data. So whenever the big data is growing like that, so whenever the growth of big data, the following things to be needed. That is the storage capacity should be increased and the processing power is also increasing and the availability data, the data availability in the different format like that. So that is that's why we go for the big data. So as per that, why we need of big data in the sense that here the big data at present that I already told you we are in the IoT world. So the IoT world, all the way the devices, the things are connected. So the people, earlier we are connected internet of people, the people is connected through the internet, but nowadays we are connected with the things, so the internet of things. So we are deriving internet of things from the internet of people. So the internet of people means the early days we are using, all the way the people used the internet. So that is the thing. So the world population 6.3 billion, billion in the 2003, but at that time the connected devices are only 500 million. So the connected devices per person is 0.08 like that. So the gradually it's increasing, but in 2020, the world population is 7.6 billion, but the connected devices are 50 billion. The connected per device, the devices per person is 6.58. So actually the drastically this improved that connected devices. So that's why we are starting from the internet of people with internet of things. So whenever we are using internet of things, automatically the big data is also very important. Why? Because all the way the devices are connected. So all the device information is stored in the form of big data alone. So that's why the big data is very important. So like we may say the example that Facebook generates the 10 terabyte of data daily, Twitter generates the 7 terabyte of data daily, and also the IBM claims 90% of today's stored data was generated in just the last 2 years alone. So that's why the big data is very, very important thing. So next, how the big data is different. So whenever the go for that big data, the big data is automatically generated by a machine. So So here we are using the sensor, some sort of sensor in that IoT devices. We are using sensor. So with the help of the sensor, the machine or the automatically generated data, the information is generated by a machine with the help of the sensor. And the second thing, typically and entirely the new sources of data. So the new sources of data in the sense, here we are using internet. So with the help of the internet or the use of internet, different sources we are using it. So that's why the big data is different. And third one, not designed to be friendly. Example, some sort of text stream. So that is the Facebook data or a Twitter data. So it's not at all that friendly manner. So that's why we are need of that big data. That's the thing. So what are the sources? There are different big data sources. The sources of big data, so all the way, we are the users. The end users or users or customers is a primary source. And apart from that, application. So all the application, all the applications are activated by the user, as well as it can be activated by the sensor also. So that's why the application, through that application, we are activating the data sources. That is the input. We are giving the input for the machine, that is an automated machine, and some sort of system. So through that system also. And through the sensors also. So these are the different sources for collecting the information, either the user or either the application format or the user systems, from the systems or from the sensors. So that is the big data sources. So how the data generation points, what are the different data generation points are there? So as of now, we are focusing that mobile devices all the way, all the time we are using the mobile, that is a smart mobile. So in that smart mobiles, the mobile devices is one important data generation point. And next thing is the microphone. So the microphone is also generating the input. And there are some sort of readers or scanners, that is some input devices, and some science facilities or some programs or software, social media, some camera. So these are some of the data generation points. So that is the thing. So that through which we are collecting the data. So next thing, what are the structure of big data? So already I told you that structure, it may be structured, semi-structured or unstructured. So when the people think about data, so normally they generally think about rows and columns of numbers. That is, rows and columns is nothing but it's a relational database. So all the informations are available in that row and column format. So that's all matching in format like that. But unfortunately, only about 5% of digital data in that format, that is a relational data format, that is a row and column format, data table format. But whenever we people think about the data in the sense, automatically we think the data is in the form of rows and columns, that is it's stored in the table format alone. But only the 5% of the data is using such a format, that is a relational format. So it is referred to as a structured data, but 95% of the digital data is an unstructured one. So that's the thing. So whenever we are using the relational model, that's why we are using all the way using the normalization or normal form like that. So the data is a 5% of data is a structured data. So automatically the information is the unwanted information. That's the thing. So all the with the help of the normalization, we can eliminate unwanted things. But as per the scenario, as per the big data world, as per in the current scenario, only the 5% of data is in that relational format. But the 95% of the data is an unstructured one. So that means almost it buried inside the machine logs, computer logs, books and document, website, legal brief notes, some sort of blog postings and some other things. So so many examples are there. So all the example, all the things is a unstructured only. So every instance is a unique digital environment. So the trick is to turn that through all the data and pull the relevant pieces out. So it is difficult, but also offers a tremendous business insights within that. So that is probably the best example of an algorithm that processes the massive quantities of unstructured data. Is a, we may say the Google search algorithm. So the Google search algorithm is the using the massive quantity of unstructured data. So it literally indexes the entire internet, including the websites, blogs, and an infinite number of unique format, and pulls out all the relevant databases. So whenever we are giving the search, keywords, automatically it will take all the websites, all the related websites, blogs, and what are the So it will, it, all the things will take it from that website. So that is the thing. So the internet is an example of unstructured data. So the another best example of unstructured data is the internet. So the emerging big data technology are allowing the companies to run the similar filters and queries on the countless other data sets. So here, as per the thing here, row and column here, the structured, we are make it structured, semi-structured, unstructured. But here we are making the processing from the batch processing, data velocity and real-time processing like that. So whenever the structured data is nothing but traditional data warehousing, demand forecasting in manufacturing, predictive maintenance in the aerospace is very, very important. At present, we are all the way, we are in the aviatics information that application, the aerospace application is using the structured data, that is a big data only. So that is a claim and tax fraud in the public sector, credit market risk, some sort of fraud detection. So these all belongs to the structured only. Semi-structured format is sometimes the text mining, disease analysis, all the social media sentiment analysis. So that belongs to the semi-structured. And unstructured is nothing but all the video surveillance analysis, all the things, social media, sometimes the social media analysis also belongs to that unstructured also. Sometimes it may be a semi-structured, so like that. So that is the structured data, this is the most traditional data sources. Semi-structured is nothing but many sources of the big data. Unstructured is nothing but is a video data, some sort of audio content like that. So that is a very important thing. So whenever that is a big data technology, so just we are moving from that moving part, that big data technology. So as per that big data technology here, we are starting that terabyte of data, petabyte, exabytes and zettabytes. Here we first we start with the fast data, big analytics and deep insights. So whenever we go for using the fast data, here we are using some big data technology. We start with the Hadoop, MapReduce, some sort of a ECL or ETL technology, Netafy, Teradata. So see, these are some of the technology we are using in terms of the finding for using the fast data. Second thing is the big analytics. So whenever we go for the big data analytics, here we are using some sort of technology. It's maybe a MATLAB or R, Python or like that, MATLAB, SPSS, SAS, like that. Next, when I go for the deep insight of big data technology, we are using all the way, we are using the predictive modeling, sentiment analysis, unsupervised learning, social media analytics, simulation or all the network analysis, business intelligence, so on. So visualization techniques. So these belong to the deep insight concept. So we start with the fast data, with the help of the data analytics and deep insight. So after performing the deep insight, that input is given to the business objectives. So that is a movement, that is a data movement from the fast data to the business movement. So that is a big data technology. What is a big data preparation? So whenever go for the data, big data, the first important thing is the preparation is very important. The data preparation is very important. So whenever go for the data preparation, okay, mainly we are focusing about the perception and reality. So the perception is nothing but is that you spend most of your time on analytics only. Whenever we go for the big data preparation, most of the time we are using that the analytics of the data. So that is a perception. But in reality, you will devote much more time and effort on importing, profiling, cleaning, repairing, standardizing, and enriching your data. So that is a preparation for the preparation alone. That is a pre-processing alone. All the way we are using that so many effort or so many we are spending much time for making it. So that is a big data preparation. So as per that, here we are focusing the data cleaning. That is the data cleaning or data cleansing. So the data cleaning is a process of detecting and correcting the removing the corrupt or inaccurate records from a record set or table or some databases. So it's a process. That data cleaning is a process of detecting, correcting, removing the incomplete or incorrect or inaccurate, or we may say irrelevant or out of date or corrupted or redundant or incorrectly formatted, duplicate, so these are some of the things. So these things will be removed. When we go for the data cleaning, all the way we are removing all the incomplete, incorrect, inaccurate, irrelevant, redundant, incorrectly formatted, duplicate like that. So that data are removed from that thing. So that is the data cleaning is very important. So the data cleaning may be performed interactively with that data wrangling tools. So we may say the batch processing through the scripting. That is the thing. After cleansing, the data set will be consistent with the other similar data sets in the system. So that is a data cleansing. Next, what's the difference between data cleansing and validation? So whenever we go for that data cleansing versus validation, here we may say one important keyword, that is a data scrubbing. So the data scrubbing is nothing but it's a process of the filtering or merging or decoding or translating the sources of the data into the validated data for data warehouse. Here, when we go for the data cleansing, 6 steps is needed. First step is monitoring the errors. Second step is standardize your processes. Third one is the validate the accuracy. We have to check the accuracy of the validate. Why? Because after removing all the things, whether the particular accuracy is there or not. So we have to validate all the way. We have to validate. Fourth important steps for data cleansing is that is a scrubbing. That is a scrub for the duplicate data. Fifth one, we have to analyze. So all the way we have to analyze. And finally, we have to communicate with the team. So these are the 6-step process when I go for the data cleaning. So the data cleansing may involve removing some typographical errors or validating and correcting the values against a known list of entities. So that is a data cleansing. Data validation is nothing but it may be strict. So that is such as rejecting any address that does not have a valid postal code or a fuzzy, that is a correcting record that partially match existing or known record like that. So that is a difference between data cleansing and validation. So that is a two important terminology in that big data. So next thing is that data cleansing may also involve the activity like harmonization of data and standardization of data. For example, the harmonization of the short code, we are making it STRD. So what is the short code for STST in the sense street, RD for road, like that. So we are making it like that also. So standardization of data is a means of changing a reference data sets to a new standard. That is the use of the example, use of the standard codes like that. Why the data preparation is needed? Whenever go for the data preparation, that is the data cleansing and validation, why is the data preparation needed in the sense it significantly reduces the amount of time needed to ingest. That is another important keyword in that the big data technology, the ingest technology, it's one process. And prepare the new data sets for the multiple downstream processes. Also, it shapes and improves your business data and render your ecosystem simple, scalable, and also as well as the automated. So that's why the data preparation is needed. So what we do, what are the things to be needed before the data processing? So before data processing, you work with the mishmash of data sources. So your content will be inconsistent, incomplete, and in a variety of different formats. It takes you weeks to process your data and write the custom script to clean up the mess. So it needs efficient strategy to harvest and analyze the data from the social media and the sales transaction. You will have only a vague idea of the categories of the information that your data might provide. So that's why the data before processing. So before processing, what about the data format, how the data will be there. So that is the thing. So for that only we go for the data cleaning, cleansing and other things. So data after processing. So whenever the data after processing, it provides the large set of data repair, transformation and enrichment options that require the zero coding or scripting. So directly we will make use of our data for the further processing. So it enables you to see the data transformation and the result of the script automation in real time with a set of smart and interactive tools and features. So that is the data after processing. So this is a preparation life cycle. So whenever the data preparation, we are having some life cycle. This is a data preparation life cycle. Start with the ingest. So there are the two main phases in the analytical life cycle. That is the discovery and deployment. So discovery process is nothing but it's driven by asking the business questions that produce some innovations. The first step is thereby, therefore, the defining what business needs to know. So the business question must then be translated into the representation of the problem, which can be solved using some predictive analytic technique. So that is a very important, whenever go for the analytic life cycle, that is a preparation life cycle, two important things to be needed, discovery and deployment. So as per that discovery, that here we start with the ingest. So the ingest operation, the data ingestion is nothing but is automatically ingested structured, semi-structured and unstructured data from multiple sources in a variety of format. So second thing is the enrich. So the data enrichment is nothing but we will see one by one. So that is the second is the enrichment. Third is the publish and the governing. So this is a preparation life cycle for the data, big data. So the ingest, so when I go for the ingest, the data ingestion is nothing but is a transportation of the data, transportation of data from assorted sources to a storage medium where it can be accessed and used and analyzed by an organization. So first we are starting with where are your data sources. So the data sources will be identified. Second thing, the destination, that is a are they office documents, social media, or clickstreams log? If so, you need to ingest your data before you can effectively analyze and enrich it. So the destination is typically a data warehouse, a data mart, a database, or the data document store. So whenever the ingest to make sense of all the data you have, you must define a structure and correlate the disparate data sets. So this important step involve both understanding and standardizing your data. So whenever the data ingestion, data is bringing the data into your system, so the system can start acting upon it. So that is one important part in the data ingestion. Whenever the data, whenever we are using the data ingestion, it's bringing data into your system and the system can start acting upon it. So the data integration is bringing data together. So that is a very important part. So the second thing is the data, that enrichment. So the, as per the data enrichment, what you can do in this and mend your data. So as per that here, and data statistical profiling. So that we have to create the standard statistical analysis of numerical data and frequency and term analysis of text data. The process it handles the multiple format of data sources, whether the content is structured, semi-structured or unstructured. Third thing is a cleansing, that is a clear, that it removes the non-essential characters and standardized date formats, and we go with the repairing. So the repairing, you find and fix the inconsistency, and we have to detect the schema, the identify the schema and metadata that is explicitly defined in the header field or tag, and identify the duplicates like that. So that is the thing. So next, enrichment. So whenever the enrichment, the data enrichment is after data ingesting, we go with the enrichment. The enrichment is defined as merging the third-party data from an external authoritative sources with an existing database of first-party customer data. So that is a data enrichment. Here the brand do this to enhance the data. They already possesses the, so they can make more informed decisions. So the data enrichment makes this raw data more useful. That is one important thing in the enrichment. So after you have cleansed your data, you can leverage any patterns and knowledge-based classification to understand the domain found in your data sets. So use a wide variety of known categories and vast array of reference data to analyze and recognize content without relying on any metadata. After classification of data sets, enrich your data sets with related entities from the reference knowledge service and extract that embedded entities found in your data. So this semantically enriches and correlates with your data. So that is the enrichment. The next thing is publishing. So the publishing, maybe we start with different sources and different target. So we can process the data automatically from a number of different sources in many different file formats. And also you can manage your data use assets using a direct integration with Oracle storage cloud service. Next, when I go for the publish, we will go for the execution. So execution here, you can invoke all the service execution and customize them through the services user interface, and you can schedule them according to your needs. and finally end up with the format. The format you can publish the prepared data sets to a wide variety of target in a rich set of different formats. So that a format may be any format as per your need. So there that format allows you to make the data available to the multiple heterogeneous downstream business intelligence analytics and the enterprise ETL process like that. Governing. So whenever go for that govern, as you ingest, enrich and publish your data, the cloud service provider provides a user interface driven or initiative dashboard page to monitor all the transform activity on your data sets. So here, the dashboard page, it provides a real-time metrics about the rows process and automated alerts and errors. So that is a very important thing in the governing. So as per the governing here, the one page is there, a dashboard page. This dashboard page, it provides the real-time metrics, that is it, about the what are the rows processed and automated alert and errors. That is the important thing. That this information can be filtered by different time slices. It will take from the 24 hours up to 30 days like that. So that backup will be taken starting from the one day, that is 24 hours to 30 days like that. So by using this dashboard pan and zoom features, you can see what is running at any time. That is also an important thing. And apart from that, this dashboard page also lets you view the types of file being ingested and the size of these files. That also easily we can viewable. So that is a governing. So that is a big data preparation lifecycle, start with the ingest, entry, governing, and the third part is also very important thing. That is a data enrichment is also very important. So that is a thing. So next we go for the automate the process. So after performing all the big data that lifecycle, what is the next step? So next step is we have to automate the process. So whenever we go for the automate the process, first you can use the scheduler to set your transformation to run on a daily or weekly or monthly basis against the predetermined data sources. Second, by using the APIs, you can automate the entire data preparation process from file movement to preparation to publishing. So that is automate the process. And the next, what are the different types of tools used in the big data? So the five categories of tools used in the big data. First, where the processing is hosted. So in terms of hosting, where the processing is hosted, based on that hosting, we are using the tool. That tool is maybe in terms of that distributed servers or cloud. Example, Amazon EC2. So the Amazon EC2 is the one processing tool that is hosted in that cloud. So the next, where the data is stored. So in terms of data storage, so the data can be stored in the distributed storage. Example, we may say Amazon S3. Third type of tool is what is the programming model. So the programming, so many type of programming models are there. Here we may say the distributed processing model. That distributed processing model, example tool we are using is MapReduce. Fourth, how the data is stored and indexed. So when I go for the data storing and indexing as per the big data concern, here the high performance schema free databases are using. So example, MongoDB is one tool for storing and indexing. Fifth one, what operations are performed on data? So the operations may be analytical processing or some sort of semantic processing. So these are some of the tools used in the big data in terms of hosting, storing, programming, indexing, as well as some sort of operations like that. So next, types of big data technologies. See, whenever go for the big data technologies, mainly classified into two types, operational big data technology and analytical big data technology. So whenever the operational big data technology, it indicates the generated amount of data on a daily basis, such as we may see the online transaction, social media, or any sort of data from the specific firms used for the analytics through the big data technologies based software. So that is the operational big data technology. That is the normal day-to-day data that we generate. The operational big data technology acts as a raw data to feed the analytical big data technologies. So actually, the operational big data technology data can be fed into that analytical big data technology. So some few cases that outline the operational big data technologies include the executives, particularly in an MNC, that is, we may say online trading and purchasing. Example, we may say Amazon, Flipkart, Walmart, example like that. Apart from that, so when I go for the online ticket booking for the movie or the flight or some sort of railway or some more. So that belongs to the operational big data technology. So the operational big data technology is nothing but all about normal day-to-day activities. So whenever the analytical big data technology, so it's an advanced version of the big data, it's a little complex than operational big data. Whenever the analytical big data technology, it takes the input from the operational big data technology only. So here the analytical big data technology is nothing but refer to the advanced adoption of big data technology, and it's a bit complicated in the comparison of the operational big data. And the real investigation of that massive data, that is a crucial for business decisions, comes under this part. So some example, we may say the stock marketing, weather forecasting, medical health record, time series analysis, that belongs to the analytical big data. So I will repeat what I'm saying, the operational big data technology, purchasing, online trading and purchasing is the best example of operational big data. Example, Amazon, Flipkart, Walmart, like that. Analytical big data is nothing but some of the domain. We may say that's marketing, weather forecasting, stock marketing, medical health record, time series analysis, like that. So that belongs to the analytical big data technology. So some few examples of operational big data technologies. Already I told you, operational big data technology, the online book, ticket booking, social media, online shopping, some sort of organization they are using on operational big data. So here we'll start with the ticket booking, any sort of ticket booking. Second thing is online shopping. Third is the social media data preparation. Fourth one is the organization. So these are some of the examples belongs to the category of operational big data. The second thing is some example belongs to the analytical big data. Here the analytical big data, stock market, weather forecast, some space mission, the mission, and medical oriented, medical application or medical records. So these are some of the applications belongs to that analytical big data technologies. So next is big data analytics and data sciences. So how we are differentiating the big data analytics with the data sciences. So all the data science activity with the big data analytic tools. So the analytic involves the use of advanced techniques and the tools of analytics on the data obtained from the different sources in different sciences. So here the data science activity is we are starting the data extraction. So the data extraction, the data analytics tool, maybe we are using a structured tool or unstructured tool. Why? Because the data may be a structured or unstructured like that. So the next is the data preparation. So the data preparation, that type of that processing by Hadoop or other tools, and the data analysis. So the data analysis will be done using the R or Python or some other tools. So that is the thing. So the big data has a property of high variety, high volume, and high velocity. So the data sets come from the various online networks, web pages, audio and video devices, social media, and some other sources. So that in that case, the big data analytics involves the use of the analytics techniques like machine learning, data mining, the natural language processing, and some sort of statistics also. So based on that, the data is extracted, prepared, and plundered to provide the analysis for the business. So large enterprises and multinational organizations use these techniques widely used these days in the different ways. So that is the data analytics involve the qualitative as well as the quantitative technique to improve the business productivity and profits. That is a very important data analytics all the way. The data analytics uses the qualitative as well as the quantitative also to improve the business productivity. The data analytics tools are used by the researchers or analysts and engineers for business organization to access the data efficiently. So there are special analytical tools that use the techniques to analyze the data sources and fresh insights. So the data here, the data is usually the real-time data produced at the huge scale. So this data is unstructured one, and the tools help to capture the data and store it and for the analysis like that. So this is the thing, the data extraction, preparation, and analysis. Next, what is the top big data technologies? So now let us deal with the technologies falling under each of these categories, which their fact and capabilities, along with the companies which are using them. So here, let us start with the big data technologies in data. Actually, this is a fourth field. We are the big data technologies are divided into four fields: data storage, data mining, data analytics, and data visualization. So let us we'll start with the big data technologies in data storage. So as per the, see, this is a data storage. See, the data storage here, so many technologies we are using: Hadoop, Rhine, so that Splunk, MongoDB, like that. Next, the data analytics we are using Spark, R, Kinium, that's Splunk, like that. Data visualization, Plotly and Tableau. And data mining is RabbitMiner and some Trusto and some other tools. So these are some of the storage, starting with the storage, analytic visualization, and mining. So we'll start with that data storage. So the data storage is nothing but here the Hadoop framework was the design example. Under the data storage, the example technology is example tool is Hadoop. The Hadoop framework was designed to store and process the data in a distributed data processing environment with the commodity hardware with a simple programming model. It store and analyze the data present in the different machine with the high speed and low cost. So it's developed by Apache Software Foundation in the year 2011. It's written in Java. So current stable version of Hadoop is 3.1. What are the kind of different companies using the Hadoop? So apart from the data storage, apart from Hadoop, some other tools, that is the MongoDB and Rhinestar. The Hadoop is using, they call Hadoop technology is using by the following companies: Microsoft, Intel, IBM, Cloudera, like that. The MongoDB is used by the MongoDB, MySQL, SQL Server, and like that. The Rhinestar is used by the Barclays and the Credit Suisse, like that. It's a data mining. The important tool under the data mining is the Presto. So the Presto is the open source distributed SQL query engine for running the interactive analytical query against the data sources of all sizes, ranging from gigabytes to petabytes. It allows the querying the data in Hive and Cassandra and relational databases, as well as some sort of proprietary data source also. So developed in the year 2013, written in Java. The current stable version is the Presto 0.2. So what company is using the Presto in the sense? Netflix, Facebook, Repro, and Checker is using the Presto. Third important tool is the data analytics, the tool for the data analytics, Kafka. Here, the Apache Kafka is a distributed streaming platform. A streaming platform has three important capabilities, that is a subscriber, publisher, and a consumer. So the, based on that, similar to a message queue or enterprise messaging system, it's developed in the year 2011, written in Scala and Java. The current version is Kafka 2.2.0. And the company is using Kafka is Netflix, LinkedIn, Yahoo, and Twitter, and some other things. So next, data visualization. That's the next important tool, the data visualization. Example is the Tableau is the important, that's the best tool. The Tableau is a powerful and fastest growing data visualization tool used in the business intelligence industry. So here the data analysis is very fast with the Tableau, and the visualizations created are in the form of dashboard and worksheet. It's developed in the year 2013, written in Java, Python, and C++. The current version is 8.2. So the company using the Tableau is Oracle, Cognos, and Qlik's. So next to the emerging big data technology. That's a very important technology, the TensorFlow. So TensorFlow is a very important emerging big data technology. It has a comprehensive, flexible ecosystem of tools, libraries, and community resources that let's researchers push the state of art in machine learning and developers. So it developed in the year 2019, written in Java, written in Python, C++. The current version is the TensorFlow 2.0, it's a beta version. It is using that TensorFlow is the Google, that Intel, and eBay, like that. So application of big data analytics all the way. So the application are different applications, smarter healthcare, home and homeland security, traffic control system, manufacturing, multi-channel scale, sailing, and telecom, trading analytics, quality, search quality, so like that. So there is a different applications. And what are the, see, whenever we go for focusing on the positive side of technology, there's some sort of negative sides is also there. So as per that, here the, some risks are there. Whenever we go for using the big data concept or big data technology, some sort of risk is also there. The risk will be so overwhelmed. Just need the right people and solve the right problem. So then only it's, some problem will be avoided. And cost escalate is also too fast. So is it necessary to capture the 100% or not like that? So many sources of big data is a privacy. That is a very important thing. The self, that is a data compression or the legal regulation that is needed. That is a needed hour. That is a important issue is the privacy issue. Next, how the big data impact on IT? So the big data is a troublesome force presenting opportunity with the challenges of IT organization. So already we said that by 2015, 4.4 million IT jobs in big data, 1.9 million itself in the US itself. But in 2017, the data scientist job was number one in the Harvard ranking like that. But even the same scenario is going on now also. So that is happening. The benefits of big data, its ability to make the better decision and take the meaningful action at the right time, and also store the data before you know and how you are you going to process it, and to run the queries without changing the data structures underneath. So that is the benefits of big data. So here some of the research projects related to COVID-19 based on the big data going on. Is some project, the worldwide COVID-19 outbreak data analysis and prediction. Here they are using the real-time data query is done and visualized. And then the query data sets is used for the SEIR method, that is the susceptible exposed infect areas recovered predictive modeling. So that is the SEIR modeling is one important technology to forecast the COVID-19 outbreak within and outside of China based on the daily observation. So this is a one research project. They started based on this SEIR modeling. Second research project, that is a short-term application of the artificial intelligence and big data, tracking and diagnosing COVID-19 cases. So that is the second project is going on. Third one, that is the same thing, the short-term application of the artificial intelligence and big data, quick and effective pandemic alert. So that is also the process going on based on the big data. Fourth project, the modeling of disease activity, that disease activity, potential growth and areas of spread. That also undergoing that research based on the big data. And fifth project, the modeling of the utility of the operating theaters and clinics with manpower projections like that. So this is a thing. These are the research project based on the big data. So I am concluding my session. Okay, the importance of big data analytics. It leads to intense the completions and increased demand for the big data professionals. So whenever the big data technology, whenever we were focusing about the data science and analytics is an evolving field with a huge potential. And apart from that, the data analytics help in analyzing the value chain of business and gain insights. So the use of this analytics, it can enhance the industry knowledge of the analyst, that is a business analyst. Apart from that, the data analyst expert provide the organization a chance to learn about the opportunities for the business. So what are the future of big data? So whenever we go for the future of big data, here the data storage and the processing power continue to accelerate. That is the thing, the data storage and the processing power. And much of the current innovation revolve around the parallel processing that facilitated by the Hadoop and MapReduce. As such, the term big data will refer to increasingly that massive data sets as time goes on. So the databases that seems unmanageable today will be commonplace tomorrow, and the data storage company like EMC, it continue to expand the capacity along the way. That's the thing. But at any one point, the organization that are able to effectively analyze their data will be the first to exploit the new opportunities via the analytics as well as the algorithms. So as consumers, we can expect increasingly that the product or service offering as a business better understand what factors influence the purchase decisions like that. So as the internet evolved, the data would be then be entered directly by the users. So the Facebook is a great example. It accumulating over 25 terabytes of fresh data every single day. So later still, the data started being generated by machines. So the building are full of the monitors, residential houses, or the smart meters, and satellite record data about our planet 24 hours each day. So these evaluation increased the data collection by orders of magnitude, making traditional data processing impossible. So this is the overview of the today's session. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes,
sir. Thank you for the session. There is one question from the one of the participants, Mr. Satyamurthy. He wants an explanation of descriptive analytics.
Predictive analytics. Yes.
Yes, sir.
What, ma'am? Do you want?
Descriptive analytics. He expects some explanation on descriptive analytics.
Descriptive analytics.
Yeah, right.
Whenever we go for the descriptive analytics, we may say some sort of the historical record, historical data to understand the changes that have occurred in the business. So whenever it describes the use of the range of the historical data to draw the comparison between previous one with this one, so like that. So that is a descriptive analysis. That is what happened in the past. So that will be take it for the current scenario like that. Even we may say that, for example, weather forecasting and other things, it's a descriptive analytics based on the descriptive analytics only, because the last 10-year data, based on that data only, we are taking today's weather like that. So that is belongs to descriptive analytics.
I think this Mr. Satyamurthy, is your doubt solved?
Sir, there's just a minute. There's another question. This student wants to know how young generation prepares to grasp data related jobs. He wants some guidance from you.
At present our students are somewhat can you hear me?
Hello,
can you hear me?
Hello sir, am I audible to you?
Yes ma'am, yes. Can you hear me? Hello. Can you hear me, ma'am? Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
There's one more student who wants to know how should he progress, like if he wants to secure a data related job. Can you guide in that?
As per that our computer science and business system course, it mainly focus about all the way that big data, that data science related courses, related things only. See, whenever that student want to choose this say career, that data scientist or like that, he actually we discuss about so many data tools, big data technology or tools like that. So MongoDB or Hadoop or TensorFlow. So these are the, some of the tools he or she is somewhat go through with this type of tools. Once it, what he is familiar with that tool, he or she may be.
Excuse me, dear participants, may I request you to please mute your audio?
One more thing, can you hear me, ma'am?
Participants, please mute audio. Okay. Any other participants, do you have any questions for sir? Do we have any other questions for participants?
Okay, ma'am. Yeah. Can we wind up?
Sir, I don't think anyone else has a question.
Yeah.
Someone is putting up something on a WhatsApp group. Let me wait for half just a few seconds. They don't have the some participants are not able to find the chat options in the Teams, so they want to put up their questions in the WhatsApp group for the FDP. Okay, I think we'll not wait for the question. In case sir, if they put up some question, I'll forward it to you. Because you also have other occupancies, I understand, at 1 o'clock, right?
Yes.
So participants, we'll welcome questions from you. If anyone has some questions, you may put up here. I'll forward it to sir and he'll answer your questions. Okay, so with that we can conclude the today's session. I thank Dr. Balakrishnan for the very easily explained data science concepts, big data concepts. He has presented it such easy and detailed contents that I'm sure even the naive participants who are new to this domain must have understood the presentation. So on behalf of Bharti Vidyapeeth, deemed to be University College of Engineering Pune, and organizing committee of this entire FDP, I extend my heartfelt thanks to Dr. Balakrishnan. I also thank all the participants for their enthusiastic and patient participation. On this note, let us conclude this today's session. We join tomorrow 11 o'clock again for the next session on data science by Mr. Devesh Rajadhyaksha. I'll share the link for the tomorrow's session in this group only, WhatsApp group only. And also I'll share the feedback and attendance link immediately after the concluding of the session in your WhatsApp group. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Balakrishnan, for his valuable time. Thank you, sir. Bye. Have a good day, all of you.